tired of the same old jack-o'-lanterns? I know I am.
Yeah, that's definitely true. I'm also just not talented or artistically inclined, but here, someone who is, Lisa Briggs, joining us now for the Bruce Company.
Thanks, Pete sounds amazing.
Out. I know, Pete.
Yeah,
you
Pete.
You go, Pete.
Power his own selfie.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't think these pumpkins do the same, though.
This one we're not going to carve. This would be impossible.
Yes. So there are gourds and squashes and... Pumpkins are kind of winter squash, where like zucchini, those are summer squashes, thin skin, made to be eaten. Winter squashes are, they will keep longer, they have thicker walls and much varying degrees of how tough the skin is. And so that will tell you how easy it is to carve. So like just
most
a regular
people are
gonna
pumpkin. Use a pumpkin, right.
Yeah, and these are pretty easy to carve. The, you know, you can get a knife in there pretty easily.
You often use the stem as a nose.
I like to use the stem on the nose.
No,
Susan is not here
like
today,
that.
So I didn't do the stem on the nose. Then there are things like, you know, like these Hubbard squashes or this is called, I forget what this one's called, but the skin, I broke snapped two knives on it.
Really?
Holy smokes.
The skin is really tough. But I like to do a more picturesque design, and then I also will put the hole in the back and then put the candle inside. And so some of this is like these berries are carved all the way through, and some of this will be varying thicknesses of flesh. So the more flesh there is, the dimmer the light will be. So you can get something that's really three-dimensional.
So you don't
like
go for the
curtains on a window.
You don't go for the really scary.
Sometimes. I tend not to do the really scary ones. I don't know.
How
I
tough
like
was
owls.
It, though, to get through that? I mean, like, is this going to take some gusto?
Once you get the skin pierced, the flesh is pretty easy.
Okay.
So that was just,
so like any project, tools are the key.
Tools are the key. I like to use, these are linoleum cutters. This one's really filthy. This is a new blade. This is the one I snapped twice last night. Yes.
Linoleum? This is harder than linoleum?
Yes. Yes.
Wow.
The skin is really tough. Go ahead, just do a little thing here. Be careful. Push it away from yourself.
Yeah, I got
okay,
it.
Now, yeah, see what I mean?
Yeah, it's
I'm getting my hand away from Mark.
Know, like,
he's doing it upside down.
And backwards.
Note to self, do
right,
not
what,
invite
what
Mark
what that here?
As a knife.
Oh, my God.
Now, do you guys know where jack-o'-lanterns came from?
No, I don't.
Okay, so it was a Celtic thing.
Oh, really?
Yes, yeah, so Halloween, the veils between the worlds were thin, and so you'd be walking around at night, and you'd be afraid that the spirits would come after you. So they would carve little faces and make lanterns out of turnips.
Out of turnips?
Well, yeah, because, you know, squashes are a Mesoamerican crop, and so they didn't have pumpkins. So then when the Irish came to the United States, they brought that tradition of jack-o'-lanterns with them.
I love that.
They brought to pumpkins, which are much easier to carve
than
turnips.
So you put this by the front door to scare away spirits?
Well, you'd carry it around.
Oh,
I mean, if you were walking around at night after dark and you didn't want the spirits to bother you, you'd have like
a
little creepy
That's
face
why they did
a turnip.
Instead of just walking around with this guy, get your workout in.
And then if you get hungry along the way, got a little snack.
Snack too.
So let your imagination run wild.
Absolutely. And, you know, these kinds of things are really fun. So even if you're not going to carve it, if your pots are looking a little tired, you can put a couple of these around your front door. And these will last until Thanksgiving. And then you can bring them inside and try to break them open with an axe and roast them.
Break them open with an axe.
This has gotten very violent.
I have had Harvey break open Hubbard squashes with an axe.
Wow. Wow, yeah, it takes some gusto, though, for sure.
And if you're picking
out delicious.
If you're picking out a pumpkin, what should you look for?
Yeah.
Okay, so now that we've had some frost, you want to be careful. So make sure that there aren't any soft spots. When pumpkins are exposed to those frosts, sometimes they'll get a little bit of rot. I like a stem, so some people don't care. So just make sure that that's firmly attached. If there are, you know, wounds and stuff, like this is just like a little break from early, but make sure that that's firm and not mushy.
It should be hard.
Yeah, it should be hard and solid. Yeah. And then if there's going to be a frost and you have them, bring them inside for the night.
Because you get the mush.
Yes. And, you know, watch out for squirrels.
The telltale
they
right there.
They won't eat these, but
no.
They will eat this.
That looks intimidating right there.
Yes.
Lisa, thank you. It's always fun year after year. I'll let you go back at this.
Yes, I have to finish this for Joyce.
Why don't we both hand the tools over? That's probably better.
Where's that
Lisa's
knife?
Hand. It's over there. It's over there in the case.
Happy Halloween. We'll see you soon. We'll be right back with the final check of your forecast.
Hey, pretty role play back.